Well, it's one of those do you remember where you were when days. So a lot is riding on the weather as we experience this eclipse.
Yeah, that's right, Corey. It looks like we're going to see plenty of sunshine around the area this morning into the early afternoon hours. So if you have plans to take a look at the solar eclipse later on this morning and early afternoon, we should be in pretty good shape. We can't completely rule out a few clouds are trying to pop up as we move toward the late morning and afternoon. It's all because of the heat and humidity that we're going to see across the area. As we zoom in a little bit closer, this is some of the forecasted cloud. As we cloud cover, though, as we move through the afternoon hours, you notice up to the north and to the west, we're still showing quite a bit of cloudiness possible across the state of Kansas, the western half of Oklahoma. You notice northeast Oklahoma looking pretty good at this time, up into southeast Kansas. Some additional cloudiness up in areas of Nebraska. We're going to see that path of totality there. But you notice into Missouri, we are seeing a few breaks here and there. So hopefully where John's at there in St. Joe's, we actually can see some breaks in those clouds, and we can have a good show up there later on this morning into the afternoon. Well, if you have plans to take a look at the solar eclipse later on today, here's a look at some of the times. It'll start right around 11:40 or so. You notice across all of eastern Oklahoma, a minute or two difference. That's about it. So around 11:40, it'll start. It'll peak at around 108 to 110. That's when we're going to see roughly about 90% of the sun covered up. And then as it comes out of that eclipse, it'll finish up about 235 to 240. So you notice it's going to be in that eclipse for about 3 hours from beginning to end. And again, right around 110 is when we're going to see it, the peak part of the solar eclipse for us. Well, we're not tracking any rainfall out there this morning. It is quiet. We're seeing mainly clear skies here in eastern Oklahoma, still seeing some few decaying showers in southern areas of Kansas. That's staying away from us. And just a beautiful shot this morning. Our downtown cameras are looking off to the east. We're awaiting sunrise. 79 degrees this morning. It is warm. It is humid. South winds around 10. We're at 76 in Skytook, also in Owosso. We've dropped to 73 now in Claremore, 74 over in Inola. The rest of eastern Oklahoma has dropped into the 70s in most areas, 77 in McAllister, 74 in Muskogee, 75 this morning in Grove. So as we move through the morning hours, we'll see mostly sunny skies. As we start to heat the atmosphere up, those temperatures warming through the 80s, we'll start to see a few clouds starting to bubble up during the midday. I stopped at right around 12:30, right in the center of the eclipse. You notice we are seeing mostly sunny to partly cloudy skies. And as we move through the afternoon, we'll see more clouds bubbling up, as we'll see the activity start to develop. A few isolated showers and thunderstorms popping up across parts of eastern Oklahoma. The chance really in any one location at about 20%, but I do expect a few additional storms today compared to the isolated activity we saw yesterday afternoon. South winds of 10 to 15, high temperatures today in the low to mid 90s, so about 3 or 4 degrees cooler today, but still with the humidity, still heat index values of 103 to about 108 this afternoon. And we're going to see temperatures tonight drop into the 70s, and we'll increase that chance of rain to 40% here in the Tulsa area. Looks like a good chance for rain and storms tomorrow. Could see some heavy amounts of rain, some strong storms not out of the question on our Tuesday. 90 degrees, the high temperature. Cold front moves through during the evening hours tomorrow. And then look what happens behind that front. We're going to see much cooler temperatures, very pleasant, much lower humidity levels as well. So a little bit more refreshing as we move through Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. Another chance for rain and storms moving in over the weekend. What about traffic? Let's take another look at it. And again, we have seen some good conditions out there, at least in terms of the traffic in most areas. We have a brand new accident, though, and this one is down around the 91st area. It looks like between Mingo and Memorial. We have an accident in that area. So if you're using generally 91st Street, you may want to try to avoid that here for a brief period of time.